Tonight on Primary News with the Hooper Huskies, we will take a look at how you can be safer on Halloween.
And also, we have Look Inside Your Curriculum Corner. Primary News will start in 2 minutes.
Child is curious.
George, look what I found.
Turn your curiosity into a lifelong love of learning.
That's a periscope.
It's one of the most important gifts you can share. Create a curious reader.
Oh, you want to build a castle like that one? This is super bedtime reading.
Share a book together today. Visit read.gov.
Hello and welcome to Primary News. This is the Hooper Ave edition. I'm Seamus.
I'm Natalie.
And I'm Logan. And we are your hosts for tonight.
Later on tonight, we will take a look at a special art project from the home of the Huskies.
But first up tonight, we take a look at changes to our curriculum in Curriculum Corner.
Hooper Avenue has a new reading program this year. The kindergarten, first grade, and second grade students are using Reading Wonders. It began in September and the kids are loving it. We had a chance to interview the teachers to ask them how it is going.
Kindergarten teacher Mrs. Lane thinks the new program is great. Her students really like the website that goes along with learning the letters. Each new letter has a different dance that the students learn. They are so excited to learn a new letter and a new dance. The first and second grade teachers also love the technology connection. They use LCD projectors to do their group work. Teachers feel that their kids are developing better phonics and independent reading skills. The first graders also enjoy stories like Nat and Sam and Alicia's Happy Day. All in all, everyone is happy at the new Reading Wonders program.
Thanks, Seamus. It's time for a short break. Coming up after the break, we look at how one art teacher at Hooper is getting students' work published on the internet.
Primary News will be back right after this.
Because when you get moving an hour a day,
you'll have more energy to do the things you like to do.
And that's a slam dunk.
Whether you like to shoot hoops,
kick the soccer ball around,
or ride your bike,
moving every day puts you on the offense
towards a stronger you.
So be a player.
Move it your way and be a player.
Get up, play, and move it your way.
Check out how to be a player at letsmove.gov.
Head online to get tips on great ways to get moving every day.
That's www.letsmove.gov.
As a parent, I know one of the most important times to be with your children is when they aren't feeling well. That's when the love and comfort of a family is essential to a child's well-being. For many families, there's a place they can go to find the support they need.
Ronald McDonald House Charities programs provide that supportive environment so families can be together while their children are dealing with serious illnesses and undergoing treatment. It's a home away from home for families in need, giving them more time for hugs, kisses, quiet moments together.
You can volunteer your time at a local Ronald McDonald House and help a family in need by cooking a meal or hosting a movie night. You can also drop your extra change in an RMHC canister.
These contributions, both large and small, help more than 10,000 families every day. Proof that a little help goes a long way. Today is a great day for all of us to show our support and help keep families in need more time together.
To find out how you can get involved in your community, visit rmhc.org.
Welcome back to Primary News. I'm Seamus. Let's take a look at our website review.
The art teacher at Hooper Avenue Elementary School, Miss Dalia, has been participating in ArtSonia for years. ArtSonia is the world's largest online art museum. Ms. D'Elia publishes students' artwork to the website. Parents and relatives all over the world can view the artwork. Parents can order items like magnets, mugs, or jewelry with their students' artwork on them.
This year, Hoopa Avenue's Art Sonia account has had over 100,000 visitors. We are ranked 5th in the state of New Jersey and 91st in the United States. Ms. D'Elia has won a leadership award for this year for Hooper's Art Sonia account donations. From Art Sonia, we have allowed us to get some wonderful additions to the art room, even an iPad, said Ms. D'Elia. We would like to thank her for all of her hard work.
Let's take a look at some more of the students' artwork as we take a look at our postcard segment. This is it, the apocalypse. Whoa, I'm waking up, I feel it in my bones. Don't make my system flow. Welcome to the new age, to the new age. Welcome to the new age, to the new age.
Moving on in our show, there have been some amazing upgrades to our technology department. Students and teachers were excited to see a giant delivery arrive at the front doors of Hooper Avenue. Inside the boxes were 90 student Chromebooks. The Chromebooks will be used in grades 4 and 5 to help students prepare for the PARC test.
We have also received LCD projectors, which are being mounted in the classrooms. And all the students in kindergarten through grade 3 will be receiving laptops, so our very youngest students will be learning to type and navigate the web. Teachers are reviewing new technology as well. Their desktop computers, which are very slow, will be replaced with faster, more portable laptops. These laptops can also be used as a tablet, which is ideal for the new curriculum. Right now we have giant boxes, but we will soon have great updated technology. We are all so excited.
Now let's take a look at Hooper's Tech Tip of the Week.
Hello, parents. If you have a child or children at home that search on your computer or tablet, this tip or message is especially for you. When searching on Google, with this tip, you can reassure that your children will be safe. And this tip is called Safe Search. Now, let me show you how to do Safe Search. Okay, all you need to do is, on the main page, type in Safe Search, simple, enter, and this screen will pop up. Press Turn Safe Search on or off, and then once you're on this page, press Search Settings on the very first line. You'll pop up to this. Then click and put in the check mark on Filter Explicit Results. Go down and do Save, and click Save. Once you do that, a Safe Search will automatically turn on. Now, with this, all you can do is sit down and relax, and you will be reassured that your children will be safe on Google.
Well, it sure looks like Hooper Avenue is an exciting place these days. It is time for us to take our last break.
After the break, we see how a special being stopped by the gym to talk to the students.
We will be right back.
Many fun things we all can do to be healthier, no matter who you are or where you are. So let's move.
Well, here we go. We're getting set to get underway.
Let's stretch in the grass.
Great play.
Let's play tag.
What a play.
Let's jump up and down.
Oh, what a way to finish it.
And most of all, let's eat better so that we have the energy we need to play an hour a day every day.
Everyone can play. Just go to letsmove.gov to learn more.
Welcome back to Primary News with the Hooper Husky News Team. Now let's travel to the gym to see how our students got a special visitor.
Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Ice cream.
Ice cream who?
Ice cream every time I see a ghost. Hooper Avenue was able to host a little ghost in a Halloween writing assembly this week. Students were excited to meet the authors and illustrator of Host a Little Ghost and the story of the Mystical Mums. The story was written and illustrated by three Toms River regional teachers who came to the school to teach students about the writing process. Students learned a lot about how the books are illustrated and published. The authors and artists were also able to come to the Hooper's family fun night to sign the books.
And wrapping up today's show, Halloween is right around the corner. This year, Trick or Treat in Toms River will be held on Friday, October 31st. Students at Hooper are allowed to dress up as well on Friday for school. We have some tips for you as you prepare your costume. First, make sure that your costume is not a tripping hazard. The legs shouldn't drag on the floor and you should be able to see clearly. Remember that although you can wear a mask to trick or treat, you can't wear one to school. There are no masks allowed.
Also, the school has rules about other parts of your costume that you need to be aware of. You are not allowed to use fake blood for your school costume. You also can't include a weapon of any kind, even if it is made of foam. For older elementary students, these rules may mean that you need to alter your costume. Remember that there are very young children here, and we don't want to scare anyone. Most importantly, have fun planning your costume and have a safe and happy Halloween. One more knock-knock joke.
Knock-knock.
Who's there?
Olive.
Olive who?
Olive Halloween.
Remember, if you have a story you would like us to cover,
or if you have an announcement about an upcoming event, please send it to Inner Schools Mail, the TV studio at High School East, or you can email us at tv21@trschools.com.
Also, be sure to tune in TV21 throughout the day to catch the show as we bring you stories from around the district. Also, please take a look at our website, www.terschools.com/TV21.
Well, that wraps up tonight's show for Primary News. I'm Natalie.
And I'm Logan.
And I'm Seamus. Have a great night.